Hello everyone, welcome to your online lecture of environment subject. Guys, right now we are in unit 4, environmental pollution. Till now we have completed with soil and land pollution, then we have seen water pollution. Now in today's lecture we will continue with water pollution. As everyone knows this, water is life and water is important. So is it allowed if water gets too much polluted? Of course not. See, we can sometimes we ignore soil pollution, air pollution, any other pollution, but we can't ignore at all, that is water pollution. So in today's lecture we will see how to treat water. Then see, this one you have again studied in your something 8th standard in science, treatment of water. So let's start. So today's point is water treatment. The combination of treatment method depends upon the nature and extent of impurities present in water. Now next slide gives you an idea about the choice of technique employed for a particular category of impurities existing in water. So let's see, here in this slide there are given different techniques for treating impurities in water. Suppose if your water contains floating matter like wood pieces, leaves, flowers, fruits, then which technique we will use? Screening or filtration. Suppose if your water contains clay, sand, dust, etc., which is also known as suspended impurity, then we use sedimentation. Okay, sedimentation means what? You remember, we settle down water for few hours and then the heavy particles get settled at the bottom. Then suppose if water contains fine suspended inorganic matter like silica, mica, fine dust, then sedimentation with coagulation. Then suppose if your water contains colloidal impurities, then we use filtration or ultrafiltration. And suppose if your water contains microorganisms or pathogenic bacteria which are not seen by your naked eyes, then we go with disinfection or sterilization technique. So these are the different impurities, and for this removing these impurities we use different techniques. Now the next point is generation of wastewater. How this wastewater get generated? From industry especially. Lead and mercury are the main toxic solid substances which come out of the industry waste and get mixed with the nearby water pool. Right? Which are the two important solid substances? Lead and mercury. The consumption of this polluted water makes a direct impact on the human health. Example, the lead pollution damages the liver and kidney. It also reduces hemoglobin formation. Lead may affect the central nervous system. This we have seen last time, right? The main source of lead to water is the influence of the lead processing industrial plants. From the paper and pulp industries, effluents, and also from the fluorescent light tubes, high intensity street lamps, batteries, thermometers. The mercury compounds enter in water body get converted into methyl mercury compounds due to anaerobic microbes. Finally, it enters in the aqua food chain and disturbs the entire aqua ecosystem of the pond or the lake. So like this, waste gets dissolved in, or waste get added in water. Then the next point is wastewater or the industrial effluents. Which are the industrial effluents? Fertilizers and detergents, domestic and commercial effluents, non-biodegradable pesticides, oil pollutants, radioactive pollutants, fluorides. See, They have the toxic chemicals like arsenic, mercury, cadmium, lead, etc. They kill the aqua life and may enter in the human body through the consumption of this aqua life, mainly the fish, and may create health problems. So first one is fertilizers and detergents. They act as a nutrients and helps to grow algae, which consume the dissolved oxygen and the biological oxygen demand increases. Reduction in the dissolved oxygen kills the aqua life. This happens because of fertilizers and detergents. Then second is domestic and commercial effluents. These organic materials provide nutrients to the microorganisms, which consume the dissolved oxygen and the biological oxygen demand is increased. So this also kills the aqua life, same as fertilizer. Then non-biodegradable pesticides. They travel through the food chain and enters into the human body and affects the nervous system. Then, oil pollutants. Through the oil tankers carrying the oil and through the industrial effluents, the oil gets spread over the water, creating a thin layer over the water surface. We know this. We have seen this. This affects the water cycle and leads to death of water, birds and fishes. Radioactive pollutants. From the mining and refining of uranium, thorium, and the radioactive pollutants enter in the human body through water and food and get accumulated in blood, thyroid glands, liver, bones, and muscles. This causes serious illness and death also. Then fluorides. Excess amount of fluorides consumption causes dental and intestinal problem. In general, consumption of polluted water generates the diseases like basically dysentery, cholera, amoebic dysentery, etc. Typhoid, we get fever, typhoid, something. Then, what are the measures to control this water pollution? First one is disinfection of water, sedimentation, filtration, and softening of water. See, actually, we can't call them as a measures to control water pollution. Actually, these are the techniques to purify your water. Through the natural water cycle, the water by itself can get converted into the pure natural form, right? Due to fast water pollution through industries, agriculture, transport, and domestic waste, we need to use various processes to treat the water to bring it to its natural status. So, following are the important techniques used for water treatment. You can see the list here. Now, let's see first, disinfection of water. It is the process of killing the organic life, that is bacteria, to make the water safe for drinking. This can be done by chlorination. Yes, that's why chlorine is used in swimming pool. If you remember, chlorine is used in the form of liquid, gas, or oxides. This is done by using bleaching powder. So disinfection from bacteria. Then sedimentation. It is a process used to remove the suspended material from water. For removing the sludge and the subtle material, different types of tanks are being used, like circular tanks have either radial flow or circumferential flow. Other types of tanks used for sedimentation are rectangular tank and hopper bottom tank. Then filtration. In this process, the water is allowed to pass through a bed of coarser and fine sand. It removes color, taste, odor, and also the bacteria. These filters are of two types, that is pressure filters and gravity filters. As we are going through this video, you might be recalling your 8th standard science, right? So everything was in 8th standard. Then softening of water. To remove the hardness of the water, two methods are used. By boiling water, the hardness is removed. By adding lime in the water, the hardness can be removed. So these are the different techniques to pure your water. Then impact of water on environment. Of course, water will have huge impact on water. Wastewater temperature affects receiving water, such as freshwater streams like river lakes. When wastewater discharged in large quantities, it can raise the temperature of receiving streams locally and disturb the natural balance of aquatic life. And of course, it also increases the pH of water, pH of fresh water. Okay, let me ask you one question. What is the pH value of pure water or fresh water? What is the range of that pH value? Your answer is 7 to 8.5. The acidity or alkalinity of wastewater affects both treatment and the environment. And the next point is, it's a flow diagram of water treatment plant. Here, you don't need to describe this diagram. Just have a look and remember what are the components of this flow diagram of water treatment plant. Because this might be asked you against the image. Like guess the image, as there is no description of this. Here, if you see, lime is added in water for purification, chlorine is added, sand filtration. Then, so like this, you have to just remember the components. Okay, there is no need to go in deep description of this diagram. So this like this we have ended or finished with water pollution. In next in next video we will see sewage treatment. So tata, bye bye.